this video, I'll show you the process of how I turn this rough idea sketch into a finished illustration. I'll show you my workflow in real time and explain what I'm doing along the way. This is a character I'm working on, a black cat named Brutus. I've gone back and forth with the character design, and I think I'm almost settled with how I want her to look. I wanted to make a quick and simple illustration from my imagination tonight, so I started off by making a rough and loose sketch. I didn't have a plan in mind, I just went with whatever came to my imagination. Since I'm drawing on an iPad, I don't worry about a thumbnail sketch. Instead, I put my idea sketch right on the first layer of my canvas. I resized the idea sketch using the transform tool. I'm going to draw a cleaner sketch on top with a new layer. The purpose of the idea sketch is to get my ideas out of my head and onto the canvas as quickly as possible before I lose them. I don't worry about getting the shapes right. If I was drawing traditionally, I would do this on a small piece of paper instead. During this stage, I'll get the lines and shapes just the way I want them. I already have a clear idea of what I want this to look like, so now I can take my time. To undo a mistake in Procreate, you can tap the canvas with two fingers. I use the quick shape feature to get the star straight. When you're drawing a line or a shape, such as a box, keep your stylus held on the canvas after you make the stroke. This will cause it to snap into a straight line or whatever shape you're making. While holding it down, still tap the screen with the second finger to snap it into a perfect line or shape. I'm done with the idea sketch, so I can hide that layer now. As I go, I'm using the selection and transform tool to adjust the shape of the characters. I flipped the sketch so I can see it with new eyes. This helps me find things that I think are off or not shaped right. I like the sketch, so now I'm going to make the clean line art on a new layer. I turn down the opacity of the sketch again so I can see what I'm drawing. Using the transform tool with snapping turned on, I can make sure my drawing is in the center of the canvas. I want it to be centered vertically and horizontally. draw the tail using one big swoop, so I make a new layer for the tail line art. After I erase the parts of the tail that I don't need, I merge the line art layers back together using a pinch motion. You can also tap the layer and select Merge Down to merge it with the layer directly below it. I go back to the sketch layer to make some more adjustments to the eyes on the skull. The line art is done, so I'm going to pick some colors. I'm keeping it simple today, so I only need one, but I picked two just in case. I alpha lock the line art layer so I can easily recolor it later. You can easily color your line art with reference layers. You'll need to make sure your line art forms a completely closed boundary. When you select a layer and turn on reference, you can drag and drop color to any layer, and the colors will fill the space all the way to the boundary of the line art. Click continue filling and tap where you need more color to save time. I used clipping mask to make the line art layer different colors. When alpha lock is set on a layer, you can also just color the line art directly. So here's the finished illustration. If you want to see more of my artwork, you can find me on Instagram or X as Cells Dividing. Leave a comment and let me know what you think. I'd love to hear your feedback. Thanks for watching and have a great week.